Praise the Lord. Good morning and welcome to our online church as we worship together online this Sunday. Despite the restrictions, we praise God that God has given us technology that we can come together to worship as one people of God. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you in the midst of all the restrictions that we are able to come together in the Spirit as we come together in the name of Jesus. We pray for your continuous presence and leading upon us as we gather in the different homes, the different places to worship you. May your name be lifted up. May your name be glorified. In Jesus' name, Amen. The Lord be with you and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give him thanks and praise. We say the collect of purity together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. We say the Kyrie eleison together. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Christ have mercy, Christ have mercy. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Let us continue to worship the Lord as we give praise to him. In the midst of our darkness, God Almighty is still Almighty. There is none like him. Of peace, he is our righteousness, for there is none truly like him. Once again, I worship you, Almighty God. There is none like you. I worship you, O Prince of Peace. That is what I want to do. I give you praise, for you are my righteousness. I worship you, Almighty God. There is none like you. There is none like you. Let us say to him, no one else can touch my heart like you do. I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like you. There is none like you, Lord. There is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. I could search for all eternity long and find There is none like you. Yes, Lord, truly there is none like you. For your word and your presence is all that we desire this time. For your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me, and nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Saying to the Lord, nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. For your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto my path. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. And a light unto my path. You're the light unto my path. Please be seated for the scripture reading from Romans chapter 8, verses 14 to 17. Romans chapter 8, verses 14 to 17. I would like to encourage each and every one of you to open your Bibles as we read along the scripture verse for us this morning. Romans chapter 8, verses 14 onwards. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. The Spirit you received does not make you slaves, so that you live in fear again. Rather, the Spirit you received brought about your adoption to sonship, and by Him we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit Himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, if we are children, then we are heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ. If indeed we share in His sufferings, in order that we may also share in His glory. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us continue to prepare our hearts to receive God's word into our lives. Father, today as we sang, Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Truly, Lord, we look to you and to your word that in the midst of this, Lord, unexpected famine, we pray, Lord, that you will speak to us, to renew us, to remind us of our identity in Christ. Lord, give us the grace that we will continue to experience your love and your touch through your word and presence even now. In Jesus' name we ask and pray. Amen. Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. As we journey on to be transformed in the image of Christ during this Lent season, we look to the Lord and to His word to be conformed to the image of Christ as we go on this path. 4 of this series. As we look to the Word, we want to begin as we reflect on this man who was part of history of Christianity. Not a very famous part of history, you must say. This man is known as David Brandt Berg. He was a leader of a Christian or so-called Christian group. Rather, it was a cult group. And this group, in the initial stages, were called the Children of God. Eventually, you will find as you go through history that the name was changed as the history went along. So when they call themselves Children of God, do they truly believe and understand it according to Scripture? See, being called children of God does not necessarily mean that we truly understand what it means to be children of God. So we are thankful that God speaks and reveals it through His Word, particularly from Romans chapter 8 this morning. Romans chapter 8 verse 14 says this, "For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God." Remember the man by the name of Nicodemus who comes to meet Jesus. And as he meets Jesus, and Jesus speaks to him and says, "You must be born again." Born again by the Spirit of God. And this is the work of the Spirit. Not only to be born again, but to be filled and to be led by the Spirit of God is what gives us the affirmation and confirmation that we are children of God. This is our identity in Christ. As unworthy we are, we understand that it is not by our own virtue or our own acts. It is by the grace of God that we are made children of God. And as we call ourselves children of God, verse 15 goes on to say to us, "The Spirit you receive does not make you slaves." That is what we were, slaves, so that you live in fear again. Yes, the reality all around is there's so much of fear. Maybe we may justify and say the fear is real. The situation, circumstances around us is clear, true. But we should not become slaves again to fear, but rather rise above. For Scripture says, rather, "The Spirit you receive brought about your adoption to sonship, and by Him we cry, Abba, Father." And the Spirit of God who is within us, in the midst of this environment of fear, enables us to realize that we have a relationship with God. A relationship that gives us a new identity, that we are children of God, and by that we are able to call God as Abba, Father. It is a very intimate relationship, a relationship born out of the work of Jesus on the cross. We are able to call Him Abba, Father, a very intimate call, a relationship that God calls us to today. So as children of God, we call Him Abba, Father, and we relate with Him likewise. But how do we know this? How are we assured of this? Is there some kind of an identity card that I can identify myself as a child of God? We thank God in verse 16 of Romans 8, the Scripture says, "The Spirit Himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children." So how do we know? How are we assured? Is it my baptism certificate? Is it my confirmation certificate? Is it because somebody told me? It is the Holy Spirit who lives within us that continuously testifies within us, with our spirit. That means in our inner man, in our inner person, in our inner being, there is that Holy Spirit that continues to affirm with us, affirm to us, affirm within us that we are truly God's children. And that is the love of God that is being poured into our hearts, that continuously testifies and affirms us that we are. So we need to listen to the testimony of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit who speaks to us. We need to be attentive to His voice, to His word, to His presence in our life. So the Scripture reminds us that we are children of God. We call God Abba, Father, and the Spirit testifies and affirms this truth again and again. But verse 17 goes on to elaborate this and says, in Romans 8:17, now if we are children, then we are heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ. If indeed we share in his sufferings, in order that we may also share in his glory. That means what scripture reminds us, because we are in Christ, because we are children of God, we also receive the blessings that comes from God through Christ. We inherit all the blessings of eternal life, not only for this life, but also for eternal life. And we are thankful that God has given us that privilege. But the scripture elaborates it very well. It says, if indeed we share in his sufferings, in order that we may also share in his glory. We want the glory, we want the blessings, but part of that process of receiving the blessings and the glory is to share in his sufferings. So we need to continue to look to the Lord in the midst of our sufferings. Yes, having to close down church may seem like a suffering for us, for many of us at this point of time. But remember, many Christians all over the world who are suffering because of Christ, those who are persecuted, those who do not have the privilege and the opportunity to worship like many of us do today. There are many who are still suffering in silence. There are many who are suffering openly, churches being burned down. They are suffering for the sake of Christ. But as we suffer, let us look to the suffering of Christ. We share in his sufferings, but we also will share in his glory. This is the promise that we have. Today, as we continued on this journey to be transformed into the image of Christ, we want to reflect on Hebrews chapter 1, verse 3 that says, the Son is the radiance of God's glory and the exact representation of his being, sustaining all things by his powerful word. After he had provided purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the majesty in heaven. So we praise God that Jesus is truly the exact representation of God's glory and his being. And he continues to sustain. He's seated at the right hand of the majesty in heaven. He is sovereign. He's ruling even now. So as we journey on, we become more and more like Jesus. As God reminds us of our identity as children of God, we can call him Abba Father. We know the Holy Spirit testifies, and we are recipients or co-heirs with Christ, the recipients of all the blessings that God desires to give to his children. So as we reflect on the word of God, let us continue to pray. Father, we thank you for leading us and speaking to us through this turmoil, through this uncertain moments in our life. We praise you that you are seated on the throne, O Lord, and we can continue to look to you, that we can trust you, that you will, Lord, make all things new. We submit and surrender our lives as we realize, are renewed in our identity in Christ. Help us, Lord, to call you Abba Father with great confidence and faith. For this we pray and ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Friends, let us continue to pray as we pray for the nations of the world and for our nation too. We ask that the Lord will minister and speak to us in a very special way. Let us pray. Can I encourage you to be kneeling or seated wherever you are? If you are able to kneel, please do kneel along as we pray together. Father God, we acknowledge your lordship over the world, your lordship over our church, your lordship over our family, and your lordship over our lives. Father, we trust that out of your mercy, Lord, you're watching over each one of us. But we pray together in unison against, Lord, this coronavirus outbreak. We pray that in the name of Jesus, all the outbreak, O Lord, will be arrested. We pray specifically, Lord, for the frontliners who are dealing with this, O Lord, outbreak. We pray for medical researchers, medical personnel, doctors, specialists, nurses, medical assistants, O Lord, those who are working in the hospital environments, to be divinely protected by you. We pray, Lord, that the vaccine will be discovered, and out of your mercy, O Lord, this coronavirus outbreak will be destroyed in Jesus' name. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we continue to pray for our nation, Malaysia. We pray, Father, for the leaders of our nation, especially for the health ministry officials and the health minister, together with the prime minister and the cabinet ministers, as they, Lord, discuss, plan, coordinate, that they will have wisdom that comes from on high, your wisdom, that all things will be done well, that you will give them the guidance, O Lord, that they will be able to accomplish your will in this nation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we continue to pray for those who are sick and suffering, homebound during this time and this season. We pray, Lord, that you will have mercy, that by the stripes of Jesus, your children will be healed, restored to good health and strength. Strengthen each of our immune system, that we will trust you and experience your love and your power and now and in the days to come. We thank you, Lord, for hearing our prayers. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. We continue to confess our sins. As we confess our sins, we trust that God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us therefore confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all men. Let us prepare our hearts to confess our sins, acknowledging that God is merciful. Together, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our fellow men, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. 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 Let us receive our forgiveness through Christ, as God's forgiveness flows into our lives. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As Jesus taught his disciples to pray, we pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. 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 The blessing from God, the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and always. Amen. Amen. Go in peace to love and to continue to serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Some quick announcements. I guess all of us are missing church at this time. Maybe a reminder that the church is the body of Christ. Beyond the building, the people of God, although we are separate, but we are one in Christ. We are aware of this coronavirus outbreak affecting not only our nation, but nations of the world. Please continue to pray. Please continue to be vigilant, to take care of yourselves and your families. We are aware of this movement control order that is effective from the 18th of March to the 31st of March, which means all church services and activities are postponed or suspended until a later date, once we are able to get further instructions from the government and also from our bishop. We want to ask for God's continuous protection upon us and to bless us. Let us bless the Lord as we say together. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget none of his benefits, and praise his name. Father, we thank you for the opportunity, Lord, to fellowship, acknowledging your presence with us in all the places we are. Thank you for the opportunity to worship, to receive your word, and to continue, Lord, to live our lives for your glory and praise. We pray for your leading and guidance upon us. Lord, in due time, until we meet again, we pray, Lord, that you will protect and lead us to fulfill your will in the midst of the darkness. Help us to be the light and the salt of this earth. For this we pray and ask in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, brothers and sisters in Christ, and until we meet again, God bless you.